Do you want to build real-world tech from zero? If yes, welcome to the Diary of an Embedded System Lover. In this video, I'm going to show you the complete roadmap to mastering embedded systems in 2025. So if you have decided to build a career in embedded systems, this video is the right video for you as I will walk you through the full roadmap to embedded
systems. Before we dive into the roadmap, what exactly is embedded system? Embedded system is a dedicated computer system designed to perform one or more specific tasks within a larger system. So, any system that has a chip on it can be regarded as an embedded system.
On our embedded systems roadmap, first we have to start with the foundation, which is to master C and C++ programming. These are the core languages of embedded systems. So we have to understand how computers work at the lowest level using logic gates, binary math, and digital circuit. So you have to understand logic gates and how to translate those logic gates into digital circuits. And you don't have to be a genius, you just have to be consistent. Once your basis in C programming and digital electronics are solid, then you can move to programming microcontrollers. And in programming microcontrollers, you can start simple with Arduino Uno, then you can scale up to ESP32 and STM32, where you get to work with various architectures and see the advantage of one over the other. Then you can also work on various mini projects by learning how to control LEDs, buzzers and motors and sensors through GPIO, PWM and analog inputs. With it, you can build mini projects like this, as you can see on screen, or we will build mini games and also control GPIO pins with your knowledge of C programming and digital electronics.
Once you understand microcontrollers, you can now use real tools such as the Arduino IDE, and then you can explore advanced tools like the STM32 cube IDE, as you can see on screen, to program STM32 microcontrollers. And you can also work with the PlatformIO, and this will help you organize large projects, debug easily, and also simulate real-time behaviors of various projects.
This is where theory meets reality, where you apply your skills by building embedded systems projects. In this case, you get to apply the philosophy of learning by doing. So you pick up a project to practicalize everything you've learned so far. So this is an IoT home automation project that you can pick to practicalize your knowledge of embedded systems. And this is an energy efficient lighting system that detects when a person is around and also when there is darkness before it turns on. And you can also practicalize with a simple automatic trash can to practicalize your knowledge in embedded systems.
Next on our embedded system roadmap are communication protocols. In embedded systems, communication protocols are rules and standards that allow microcontrollers, sensors, displays, or hardware to talk to each other within a system or with external devices. And here are the communication protocols. So we have the I2C, we have the SPI, we have the UART, and then we also have the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi modules that are connected to board. So now you learn how to connect devices. So I'm going to be showing you a project, for instance, that I use the I2C. So this is an automatic pill dispenser, and the use of the real-time clock, which is a DS3231, is a show of how to use I2C when working on a project like this that requires a communication protocol. So here is another project on bus validator where I use the SPI. And here is a project where my knowledge of Wi-Fi helped me in building this smart trash can. You have mastered the basics. Now it's time to go pro. Phase 6 is about building smart, responsive, and multitasking embedded systems, just like the ones in drones, wearables, and automation. So, next on our roadmap is RFTOS. RFTOS, which means real-time operating system, are specialized operating systems designed for embedded systems where timely and predictable responses to events are critical. So they manage tasks, they schedule resources, and handle interrupts to ensure time-sensitive applications perform as required, especially within strict deadlines. So unlike general purpose operating system like the one you have on your computer, RFIDs prioritize deterministic behavior, meaning tasks are completed within defined time constraints. So you can head over to the FreeRTOS website to learn more about RFIDs. You can learn about the fundamentals on the website. So when you go down, you can click on the View Beginner's Guide. There you can read about RFIDs. You can learn about it. You can even check on some of the projects that you can work on to get yourself started with real-time operating systems in embedded system. All right, so RFIDs is a very key concept to learn, especially when you want to understand scheduling and multitasking in embedded system. And this is a very, very important concept to learn, as it will help you manage tasks at once with reliable timing. All right, so you can just go to this free RFIDs website. It's free, just go there and you can learn about the fundamentals and read up on every essential detail.
Did you enjoy this video? If you did, smash the subscribe button, like, just give me a thumbs up, and drop your comment about the video and the next project you would want me to upload in this channel, and see you in my next video. Thank you for watching, and bye bye.